about them not having teeth.
Really? Interesting. All right.
You know, it's an interesting person to return a rental car to, but you know.
Doubles. Losers, semis. Right.
Stranded, Daniels. Brody Bros, Dark Park. Whichever name they want to go by. Definitely not calling them Dark and Josh Brody. So, both of them just sort of, you know, staying side to side. Oh, nice.
So yeah, in the bracket, this is Loser Semis.
Right?
Yeah. So then we'll go play Tahoe's Court.
Yeah. And then the winner of that plays you guys.
Yeah. So, it's nice to be in a winner side grand finals.
Yeah. It feels a lot like that Pew 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 SFAT sort of thing.
Yeah.
Like neither you or D-Tan are like, you know,
amazing singles players.
Like, you know, you're like your top singles players, but you're not like, you know.
Yeah, like, I don't know. Court and Tacos are both like top 25, right? Or wait, no.
Something like that.
I think Court dropped down a bit this year.
Oh yeah, because he doesn't play Link anymore. He needs to play Link.
But
stick to your Twitter handle.
I was the lowest ranked player in that.
Yeah. I mean, D-Tan is good, so it's not like it's completely analogous.
We play a lot of doubles in Colorado.
Yeah, no, you can tell. You guys are like always setting each other up, or like just sitting in that like place where it's like, yeah, you throw it here and I'll be right there. In the meantime, not really much of a stock difference. Although there wasn't one.
Nice pickup by both.
Actually, there still isn't really much. It's still a one stock lead, and one of the Pikas is 5%. Looks like it's that Pika. It's the only downside of having both Pikas. I can't tell which one it is by the icon.
Good pickup by Dark Horse. That's why Kirby's so dangerous in team. You put yourself in the wrong spot, and
he just handles
gets a downer, and stocks. Quick stocks like that are very valuable. How you make comebacks.
That's how you make that money. Alright, so now the stock count is actually even. But Dark and Burke are a little bit behind. Just because of the fact that they're both like relatively highish percent. Especially Kirby at 78. And
Dark
probably not gonna make it back. Yeah.
Dark was reaching with that last aerial and got punished.
Yeah, and now down to two.
You know, this isn't too hard. You need to play good for once. Like, you got your last stock. Play good on your last stock, and you can even this out.
Yep. I don't know. That was an interesting decision. I don't know if, like, that was the right decision, but it looked okay. Like, hitting, whoever it was. Alright, down air. And that looks like that should do it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good edge guarding. Textbook Pikachu edge guarding there.
Yeah.
Pikachu on Pikachu.
Spark's never gonna drop that, really. Unless it's like something crazy.
Great combo started there. Spark not able to get anything off it, but good damage.
Big shaft. All right, so this is really, yeah.
They played solid that last.
I don't know what else to say. It was just
solid play.
Yeah, back and forth for a little bit, and then you know just stick with it.
Team battle. So,
on to game two, which I believe this is 3 out of 5 as well.
Yes, top 4 is 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
One, so. Go.
And. Both Pikas trying to get top flat, or all three of them anyway.
The meta's really going that way.
Like if you
normal
have the top
doubles,
flat.
It's like your Kirby wants to take the top flat. You want to help him get up there as a Pikachu.
Yeah.
And then as the other team, double Pika, you don't want to let Kirby just sit up there and tack on down airs whenever he can.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Kirby being on the above you is always a threat. You have to respect that in doubles when Kirby's above you.
Gotcha. Oh, nice. Gets that back air from the ledge. So that takes that stock away.
Yeah.
And I think really the only real shame about Kirby, and it's the same for like a lot of characters in doubles, it's just like they, unlike in singles where it's like some characters are combo food, others are like less.
Yeah.
Just about every character in doubles is combo food.
Oh, if you're passing, yeah.
Yeah. There's no... Like, Pika really only gets around it because they have the upbeat. But even that's like, not always gonna save you. Shark going a little bit low there. I don't know if that was necessary, but...
What time is it?
3
o'clock, alright.
It's lunchtime, that's what it is. I need food.
Not quite enough on that 139. That'll be it.
Yeah.
Alright. Yep, smart. Hang on the ledge, wait for your invincible Pikachu partner to come back.
Yeah. Invincible Pikachu is a pretty good Pikachu.
Ooh. Classic.
The dark special.
Yeah. The dark special?
Yeah.
Or Shrews gets D-tan.
He says that's his favorite thing to do as Kirby. Is like watch a Pika try and come and edge guard him. And he just does jump down air.
In Colorado we call it the D-tan special.
I guess any Kirby would have that as their special.
I always hear it called Shears Gets Baited.
I mean, pretty much. Alright, so we got 5 stocks apiece, but most blue Pikas are high percent. So, he tries to take high, but doesn't get it. So now it's 2 stock lead. Oh. Yeah, that was a little bit misspaced. Definitely did not want to hit Brody. Oh, eats him. Eats him for safety.
Good. Dual edge guard there.
Yeah. Oh, and
some miscommunication there. They both wanted to zip to the ledge. not a good look.
My ledge. No, I'm already holding on to the ledge, but I won. Alright.
I think in that situation, you should probably split up.
Just ignore the...
If you're going to go to the ledge, go to the opposite ledge of your partner.
Yeah. That ledge is completely open. Oh, and they are getting comboed. But Pika partner was gone. Yeah, not really looking close. Both times. Just, I don't know. It didn't really feel like either team pulled away, but it always feels like Dark and Josh just somehow find a way then.
It felt like Red Team was in control for most of that match, regardless of the stock count.
Yeah.
They're thinking about the switch to Kirby.
Ooh.
They're seeing all those quick down air kills.
Pika Kirby's better than double Pika.
I like to play Pika Kirby more than double Pika.
I don't know. Double Pika just feels weird to me. But then again, I'm not a great doubles player, so. That is my limited experience.
I think you're pretty good at doubles.
Pikachu!
It's not something I like focus too much on.
We're gonna stick with it.
Stick with double Pika. And Pika Kirby. Let's see what happens. Good quarter. Oh. The extended back throw.
Oh, so much damage on Bruce is happening right now.
Oh wow, nice positioning for the forward air. Like so that way it's just not an edge guard situation.
Yeah, you want to keep your most of the time you can keep your teammate on stage low percent.
Nice. Both teams doing a good job intercepting these Pika back throws.
getting off the ledge and getting off strong here. We got red team off stage now.
Alright, so four stops
in the air. He's the edge guard, no save.
Yeah. So, I would say this is rough. Not even.
Feels like they're hitting that stride now.
Although positioning there temporarily favored red team, and oh wow, what an option select.
Yeah, good pickups from Dark, both of those, that F smash and then air. Lead.
And right now, red team's just got center stage. Sort of holding under this platform. Yeah, blue team is starting to lose ground here. They need to get something started here. I mean, this is your last game. You don't got much left to work with. Alright. So it's trying to take control of that center, but got grabbed. Oh no. Yeah.
Good pickups from Dark.
Yeah, this is getting out of control here. They tried it a few times to take control of that center, but
Dark's doing a great job of picking up, not letting the Pikachus live at high percent. It's getting these pickups left and right.
And they're also doing a good job of, like, you know, when one of the Pikas is trying to get that center stage, they're not letting the other Pika join them. Like, they're just keeping them separated really well. Like, right now, they're both, like, just keeping the center, but if they want, they're just, like, keeping them separated out. Oh, wow. Nice. What a change.
Nice target switching. Target switching is so important in doubles. You can't focus on one character too much. You get focused in on the combo.
And it also just demonstrates your general awareness about what's happening.
Yeah, awareness is so important in doubles. You need to watch four players at once.
Yeah. All right, so last back for both players on blue team. Oh, and that would have definitely killed. Yeah. That was a really nice job by him. I believe that was straight in there.
Dark, let's go legend here. Okay.
Alright, so stranded. Looks like it's all up to him now. Or no. Daniels makes it back. So now it's on Daniels, but
nice.
Yeah, it just kept on getting worse and worse there. Dark and Bark. Just kept on going. Sort of like a little Energizer bunny. Just kept on playing doubles. And eventually just, you know.